Good morning and welcome to the Stahls TV Morning Show. This is our 85th episode. Well on our way to 100. And Stahls, if you didn't know, is celebrating 85 years in business here in 2017. We're excited that you've chosen to join us this morning, whether you're joining us through the GoToWebinar client or through Facebook Live. We see some comments coming in there. Kevin, we know you're embroidering hats while you watch. And Janine, we're ready too. From Bay Village, Ohio. We're in, what is this, Uniontown, Pennsylvania.
Yes,
yeah, I almost forgot because Courtney is actually from Northeastern Ohio. Is that where Bay Village is?
Yeah. Northeast Ohio.
Okay, so she's been there. Janine, welcome to the show. So today's episode is, I personally think it's an exciting one. We're going to profile some companies that are in the decorating industry. They do a wide range of different things, and each one of us has come up with one company to profile. And our goal will be to kind of take lessons from all of these companies and how they might apply to our viewers this morning, just decorators across the country. Before we get into that, we want to show you the look of the week. So let's take a look at that.
So this week's look of the week is from Emily Carroll Fall, submitted on our Facebook page, shared on Saturday, from RLC Shirts from Ashford, Alabama. A couple things we like about this particular look. Number one is it's incorporating patterned heat transfer vinyl, which is a new exciting product from Stahls and one that we've loved seeing what customers are creating. There are quite a few shares of utilizing patterns and on Facebook this weekend. Also incorporating, you know, an oversized monogram and a very popular sort of vine looking font that's welded together nicely for a completed monogram look. And on a raglan shirt, which are also extremely popular. So one thing I want to point out, just something that's shareable from this, is while this may be personalized for an individual person with a monogram, monograms can be very popular, even leveraging the names of teams, high schools, just incorporating sort of a monogram design element, but repeating the same design over and over for a large group. So congratulations, Emily, on winning this week's look of the week. As always, if you want to submit and enter, there's a few ways to do that. Email us, tv@stahls.com, share them on Facebook, or tag us on Instagram would be the three ways to share.
All right, so because it's such an exciting episode, we brought Jimmy and Courtney on.
And they're back.
They are back. They've both been away, one for significantly longer than the other.
Yeah.
But we'd like to hear from them on their trip. So Jimmy, where'd you go? What'd you do? What'd you learn?
I actually had the liberty of going out west a little bit to the Phoenix / Scottsdale area. I had a chance to go to the Universal Laser Systems facility. Excellent facility, beautiful area. I had the liberty of Dave training Phil and myself on the full line of the Universal Laser Systems. We've been trying, you know, to do some great things with the CAD cut. Stahls products and laser, you know, systems by Universal, in the test phases, we're going to have some more videos to come, and let's hear it from Courtney.
Well, wait, we're not going yet.
You don't get to throw it.
What?
Let's take a look. So one of the reasons we sent Jimmy and Phil out there to gain knowledge and experience is because we have a new toy in the studio. A little more than a toy, actual business tool from Universal Laser. We have one of their 50-watt lasers that we've brought here into the Stahls TV studios, and the reason we've brought this in is because it relates every bit to an apparel decorator to a heat printer with some new exciting ways to process heat transfer film materials. And so let's zoom in on some of our initial testing that we were able to dial in here. The idea that we can process heat transfer films with a laser to achieve detail, you see there with the Tiger sleeve print, that it was unable to be achieved through normal vinyl cutting and weeding, and then also to distress CAD cut materials. And I mean, this is just an exciting piece. Our ideas are swirling, and I know we're going to bring some fresh new educational content for laser cutting to show you how that works. So that was Jimmy's trip, and Jimmy, go ahead and throw that over to Courtney now.
Let's hear from Courtney Singer.
Thank you, Jimmy, for that intro. So I was away for 3 whole weeks. I definitely missed the office. I was in Asheville, North Carolina, doing yoga teacher training, which on the surface doesn't really seem like it would have much to do with my position here. But I got a lot of great insights on how to teach and how to communicate better with others. And I think that bringing that into the studio will be great.
You seem a lot less nervous on the show this morning.
I am. So the biggest takeaway I've got from it is if you doubt yourself, you'll never be able to grow. So self-doubt creates stunted growth. So you have to be confident in what you're doing and know that what you're providing for your customers is valuable.
Okay. So I'm sure that a lot of our customers, actually almost any entrepreneur, is going to struggle with doubt at some time, whether their business idea is a good one, whether they know how to get sales, or whether they know how to run production. Whatever part you are struggling with, that's what we're here for at Stahls TV. So with that, we are going to jump into a few company profiles. We're going to start with Josh. And Josh, in rehearsal, I thought you had one of the more interesting presentations. So let's see if it holds up here while we're live.
Good. So I'm going to jump into a company called Danger Press, which is a screen printer out of the Atlanta, Georgia area. And I'm reading a comment that you're having a hard time hearing, Rita. So if you can type specifically who you're having a hard time hearing to let us know on the Facebook page, that would be helpful. So dangerpress.com is the website we're going to jump into. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. And this company I had the opportunity to meet back in September, I believe, at the SGIA show in Las Vegas. And so on the surface, you sort of look at their website and you're like, this is a really good screen printer. They're associated with a lot of big brands. Some of the things that they do focus on is water-based or discharge screen printing, just generating super soft looks onto apparel utilizing the screen printing process. Now, their affiliation or business they do with Stahls is really interesting because it's for a separate extension of their business that provides event printing. So obviously, it's very difficult to take a screen printing press to an event. So they've launched a division called Live Danger, livedanger.net, where basically they set up with heat printing equipment and heat press transfers onto t-shirts, bags, and other items at events, whether that's a concert, a festival, you name it. And so there are some real, I think event printing is a growing trend right now in apparel decorating, and it's something that a heat printer can really leverage. And so for that reason, I wanted to profile this company, sort of share how they do it, and then also share some tips on how you may want to consider event printing as apparel decorator. And so in order to share that, the owner, one of the owners of their company, Ed Jewell, actually the guy that I met, created a video that explains the process to potential customers. I'd like to share that with you now.
Everybody, this is a line for t-shirts only. You can walk right in.
Live Danger is where we come and set up our mobile print shop anywhere you want to sell or promote your brand. This gives your fans the opportunity to interact with your brand in a unique, personal, and meaningful way because they're actually taking part in the production process. They get to decide what shirt color, what size of shirt, what design from a menu of designs we offer that day, as well as where on the shirt they want that print to be. Front, back, upside down. So they walk away with a shirt they've actually designed themselves, which becomes a conversation piece and makes them more apt to want to wear it. At promotional events where we're giving away shirts, hundreds of people line up every single time. We can output probably 200, maybe 250 per hour. While for sale events run a little bit slower because people want to decide exactly which design, which shirt, how the shirt fits. So that definitely slows the pace down a bit. Cost is contingent on a few factors. One, there's a setup fee for us to come and set up the gear at your event. Two, what are we going to be printing on? Bandanas are cheaper than tote bags, which are cheaper than t-shirts, which are cheaper than sweatshirts. The next will be the design menu for the event. Whether we do one design, two designs, 10 designs, one color print work, two color print work, all these things factor into the bottom line. Because there's so many variables to cost, We'll work with you to develop a quote based on exactly what your needs are. Every time we've set this up, people love the opportunity to create their own one-of-a-kind t-shirt, almost as much as we love giving them the chance to do it.
So you can see from that video, heat printing is really the perfect technology for event printing. By heat printing, they keep their sort of inventory liquid and they don't commit the transfer to the size and color of the shirt until they have a customer that wants that combination. Mm-hmm. And they're able to sort of pre-print screen printed transfers or order digital transfers pre-done and then really allow customization from a placement standpoint. Where do you want this? Do you want it turned upside down, sideways, whatever, and sort of let the creative element be based on the placement rather than carrying hundreds of different design options and SKUs. So really simplicity, but customization within that. And so some benefits of event printing is you get that sort of impulse buy. You're able to command a little higher value. And as you may have heard in the video, I love how they sell it more as a t-shirt experience. And so rather than they try to sell to the event as if the event should fund the t-shirt. So if they're going out and printing at a concert, the idea that the concert organizer or sponsor can fund 1,000 shirts printed for free as part of the experience and really the advertising behind it. It's a great way to sort of pre-sell walking into an event.
Yeah, I thought it was interesting that this seems like a company that's young and would focus on technology. Mm-hmm. They're using paper order forms.
Right.
So it still works.
Yeah, it still works. Sometimes it's the simplest way. I mean, when you're out in the field, heat pressing or whatever, it may be sometimes paper is the simplest way. And it's interesting, like even with fundraising, which I know we're going to go a little deeper on before, I've talked to customers that find that the paper order form still generates more orders than the digital format. So there's something about being able to have the paper order form to circle, to fill out, to hand back in. So I think, you know, this company's cool. They're a growing company. They do the event and printing aspect of it very well. And then a couple of the other things that I like that I wanted to point out for success at an event was just to, he mentioned bandanas or t-shirts, but you could take bags, bandanas, headbands, just one size fits all items are going to make it much simpler to manage your inventory. So rather than having to stock extra smalls and XLs and everything in between in all these colorways, if you can print on a backpack at an event, it's a one-size-fits-all solution, and so it'll simplify how you prepare and approach event printing.
Makes sense. All right, thanks for the profile, Josh.
No problem.
If anybody has any questions specific to Danger Press, you can feel free to write those into us on Facebook Live. We'll do our best to answer them, or on the GoToWebinar client. That takes us to our second company profile, and that is going to be from Courtney.
Yeah, so the company profile I chose was Molly and Lola. They have a really cute Etsy shop that we have pulled up here. Their aesthetic is very floral, very light, airy, and fun. But they specialize in clothing anywhere from newborn up into young school children. So we have everything here from onesies, tutus, bows, raglan, tees, anything you can really think of for that age group.
Okay, so I see lots of kids' names on their page. Is personalization something that they're specializing in?
Yeah, so the company specializes in a few things. Number one, you can see here that it is an outfit. So this is my personal favorite thing about this company is that they're creating a easy way for moms to, who maybe don't have enough time at home, to make this outfit, make their daughter look cute and have something to match without having to go to multiple retailers to get that extra tutu, that extra headband. But they also do customization, so they can switch out names on the shirts. You can do that at checkout. You can also customize colorways on a few different items. In this example, we're pulling up here, the heart in the middle can be switched out, and you can order a bow to match, which is very cool.
Okay, so I see they have, Etsy is nice enough to publish the feedback that people leave for them, and also the number of sales that they've realized on Etsy. And they have, I mean, at least what I would consider pretty high numbers. Why do you think that is? Because competition is fierce on Etsy.
Competition is fierce on Etsy, yeah. If you look there, there's a perfect five-star rating. Mm-hmm. So they're doing something right. Obviously, the prints themselves are very cute. The outfits they're creating mm-hmm. are stylish. And it has to probably do with, you know, good customer service, good turnaround time, and being upfront with your customers in the beginning. But what I love most about this is the photography. Mm-hmm. And I think that photography can generate sales more than we think. So having a really clean, light, airy look makes customers look at that and maybe see it in their own life.
Okay, so for some of our viewers today who might not be great photographers, do you have any tips, apps, software that they can use?
Yeah, so I personally believe that anyone who is willing to put their mind to it can be a great photographer, and taking good product photos is definitely key to generating sales. Mm-hmm. So if you're kind of technophobic, you can always use an iPhone and take a photo there. You just want to make sure that you are up against natural light, facing a window, so that your item is mm-hmm. is being shined on evenly. Morning is best for this. And if you do decide to do an iPhone, there is a great app called Filmborn that can help you edit those photos. And there's a ton in the App Store if you just go on and take a look. But what you're looking for is initially good lighting. Mm-hmm. And if you're savvy with technology, just consider investing in a camera. And as you grow, your photos will become better.
Okay. So I know my daughter, when she has her friends over, they'll make all of their videos that they're going to post online. They'll stand in front of the window to
yeah.
do that.
They're smart. They know the good lighting.
Yeah. They learned that from YouTube. All right. Anything else that we should know about the company that you're profiling that might help our viewers?
I think that the idea of pairing items is a really good thing. So creating an upsell, if you're selling a t-shirt and maybe children apparel isn't your thing, but you're into sports, you can decorate anything from hats, you can mm-hmm. decorate shoes, socks, warm-up gear. So just pairing items will make it a lot easier for your customers to be able to go into one spot, have a lot less headache, and it'll make you more money in the long run.
Okay, sounds good.
The one thing I'd like to point out, if we can just bring back up the screen, so not only are they pairing it, but they're making it a part of the same shopping experience, right? Mm-hmm. So if I want everything in this photo, or just a portion of this photo, I can select it at checkout. And so being able to package products for more profit is key in how they even deliver their item listing to a potential customer.
Definitely. Most people just, you know, sell the t-shirt, and I like that you can have just the t-shirt. You can have t-shirt and tutu, t-shirt and bow, really anything that you would need.
Okay, sounds good.
Cool.
Thanks for that profile.
You're
welcome. And welcome back.
Thanks, great to be back.
Oh, good. So, Jimmy, you are up next. Who are you choosing to profile today?
Okay, I picked booster.com.
Okay.
And I'll be taking us to booster.com because, you know, things happen in life that you can't essentially plan for. You know, family members get sick, injured, you know, et cetera. And a lot of times you may need, you know, some supplemental income to help pay for bills, treatments, et cetera. Mm-hmm. So, a popular fundraiser as of late has been GoFundMe. So think of Booster as a GoFundMe, but instead of, you know, taking strictly monetary donations, mm-hmm. You raise money by selling custom apparel to support the cause. So it's pretty easy to get started with Booster. They're backed by Custom Ink, so if you're familiar with Custom Ink's designers, they're fairly easy to navigate. They have a ton of, you know, font options. They have special effects you can throw on there, you know, distress looks. You know, they recommend that you keep your design fairly simple, you know, like a 1-2 color, one-sided mm-hmm. Design. You can also use pre-made templates that they have in there. You know, if you're not a t-shirt decorator, it makes it quick and easy. They also have a variety of blank garments, you know, whatever you think your donors will essentially get behind, you know, mm-hmm. whatever you think's popular for that. So it's a really great way to, you know, make money for a fundraiser. You can set your you know, quantity goals on the right. You can set the price of the shirt. It'll give you, you know, your estimated profits, you know, how many quantities you need to sell.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so if I'm going on here and I want to raise funds for something, one of the things that would help to sell me is that number on the top right-hand corner that we see, the potential profit that we can make, because obviously you would assume that you have a goal mm-hmm. on any fundraiser. So how can decorators who are watching today that might not have the online experience be able to turn that into something that they can do locally?
I mean, you would have to, you know, maybe collaborate with whoever wants to do the fundraiser, but, you know, the profit margin's really going to be in the quantity, so, you know, maybe set your goal at 300 t-shirts for the mm-hmm. community. You know, you're going to order your products, your blanks. They're going to be cheaper per piece the more you know, obviously order. So you could definitely get some profit margin that way. You know, you take a little bit. Most of it goes to the fundraiser and then the donations, et cetera. So that's a good way to get behind it. You could also, you know, use heat transfer vinyl. You could do CAD cut templates for that. You mm-hmm. could do screen printed transfers from Transfer Express. You know, you have a lot of different means of creating those shirts.
Yeah, this also, I think, could double for the small town decorator as a way to get their name out if you offer perhaps a discounted price by putting your logo on the left sleeve to get the cause out, because people want to get behind causes. As you mentioned, GoFundMe, people donate money without expecting anything in return, but mm-hmm. to get a t-shirt out there, mm-hmm. it just helps to raise awareness.
Yeah, and it's great because, you know, if those t-shirts are out there, somebody is going to ask you about it. You know, mm-hmm. I've had people come up to me, just random t-shirts I made, just ask me what's on my shirt. So they're going to come up and ask you, and from that, you kind of almost get some free marketing, because they're going to be like, oh, where'd you get them done at? You know, could kind of kick it back to the t-shirt shop, or if you did it yourself, you'd be like, hey, I made these. You mm-hmm. know, so it's a great, you know, marketing tool. Pretty much everybody wins at that point.
Yeah, I love screen printed transfers for this sort of product offering, because when you're doing a fundraiser or campaign, typically there's a start and a stop time, so it really allows you to leverage the grouping of orders and being able to order transfers and garments and bulk to save on cost, save on freight. So and it helps you manage the business better, not managing a bunch of one-off small order quantities. Mm-hmm. Set some benchmarks, set some goals, 50 pieces, 100 pieces, just, you know, follow the example here, just take it into more of a local format.
And if you did decide to go through Booster, I mean, you don't have to worry about any of the logistics. They're going to handle all the shipping and everything, you know, that's stressful about creating large quantities of t-shirts. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, you might be thinking, well, how does Booster make money? Well, you know, they make some profit by adding, you know, the cost to host and manage your campaign, you know, into the price of the items that you sell. So mm-hmm. there will be a little bit, you know, but it'll just be marginal.
Okay. Sounds good. This
there's some questions coming through GoToWebinar. Joe, are you mic'd up this morning? Okay, Courtney, do you mind stepping over there and reading us a couple of those questions off of the production screen? I know there are a couple coming up. We want to make sure we stop and answer questions. We welcome someone watching from Ghana, West Africa. We'll respond to your questions a little more detailed about shipping internationally. So we'll respond to that directly after the show, but we certainly appreciate you attending. What questions do we have coming in from GoToWebinar?
All right, so Kimberly says, love event printing idea. We have done it several times for smaller events. Etsy shop is also cute. A commonality and something I am seeing increased issues with is trademarked phrases. Currently, someone is trying to trademark ring bearer. Any thoughts or suggestions on us decorators?
That's a good question.
That's a great question.
One of those that become difficult to answer live on air without a lot of research, to mm-hmm. be honest. So obviously you don't want to infringe on anybody's trademark phrases. I would have a hard time believing that common phrasing like that mm-hmm. Is going to be issued a particular trademark. But I mean, the best suggestion I can give is do the research, try to be original in some of your concepts. And one of the things we're showing here and going to continue down the path is sort of reaching different niche markets. So if you can sort of be on top of pop culture and any sayings, phrases that are sort of fresh and not trademarked from pop culture, it's mm-hmm. going to allow you to capitalize there. Is there a follow-up question to that, Courtney? Are we all good there?
No follow-up.
Okay. Any additional questions we need to handle right now before we do our last profile?
We have a question from Pat asking, what was that app?
That was your photography question.
Sorry. That is, there's a Filmborn app. If you go on to...
Spell it?
F-I-L-M-B-O-R-N-E.
Okay.
Yeah, if you go on the App Store, you'll be able to find that either by typing in Filmborn or Maston.
Okay, excellent. Come on back on the show with us. Thank you.
All right.
We're short on mics. We have a lot of people on the episode today, so we set up with the four microphones. We'll have to fly back and forth for those questions.
No problem.
All right, Zach, you have the last featured profile today, and this one was really interesting as well in the rehearsal, so go ahead.
Of course.
Of course it is, right? Not as interesting as mine.
No, of course not. So the company that I like to profile is called Savage Ultimate. You can find them at savageultimate.com, which will take you there right now. But if you want to do any follow-up work, we don't have enough time to cover everything that this company is doing, but there are a few key parts that I'd like to show you. So the first thing I want to show you is their partnership. So Josh, if you'll click on the partnership tab, top left-hand side, and click on sports. So what Savage has done is they have made a business out of niche markets when it comes to sports. Normally, if we're looking at sports partnerships, we're going to expect to see basketball, football, maybe some youth little league. But here, Savage has partnered with Ultimate Frisbee Leagues, they have partnered with Spikeball, and they have even partnered with Quidditch Leagues. So if you don't know what Quidditch is, you're not alone. I don't either. I know it's from the Harry Potter series. It is a game that they play in the books and in the movies. So if you want to learn more about Quidditch, you can check it out. Harry Potter fans, or ask Courtney any questions because she is a Harry Potter fan. But one of the really cool things that Savage has done for these niche leagues is built packages. So here we have a $39 beater package, and you're going to see beater, chaser, seeker packages. Those are names of positions in Quidditch, so like quarterback, linebacker, that type of thing. But basically, what Ultimate has done is put together everything that they would need, from t-shirt to shorts, to play Quidditch. They're not selling the broom, which is part of the game, but
could you customize that as well? Is that allowed?
You certainly could, I believe, with non-apparel or signed vinyl. You could definitely stick to a broom. So Savage is super niche marketing. Courtney's company was targeting five-year-olds and less, or the mothers of those people. Jimmy's company was targeting people who want to raise money for causes. Josh's company was targeting people who hold events. These guys are niche ultimate sports that happen mostly on college campuses. So the other thing that we want to look at is the events tab under partnerships. And this one also ties in to Danger Press as well. But Savage does events a little bit differently than Danger Press does. They want to be at your event in a number of different ways. First, the base level sponsorship. Savage has built a package that they just ship a box of shirts with whatever the logo or the graphic is for that particular event that the event owner can sell on their own. That Savage isn't showing up and doing any decorating. All the decorating is pre-done. They sell that there. The next package that they offer is if you say that your event is powered by Savage Apparel Company, they show up, you get discounts, and they sell a lot of different items. They also sell the game discs for the Ultimate Frisbee and some other special items, but most of their sales are in apparel. So one other thing that they do more traditional to the decorating market is under the Customize tab. If you go to screen printing, a lot of our viewers know what screen printing is, probably have done screen printing at some point in their life. In addition to screen printing the graphic on the front, they combine Stahls die cut numbers to customize the back as well. So they offer a name and number option. As you scroll down, the player number is $3, player name is $6. And then a little further down, one of the really cool things that I think that they do is they define what their turnaround time is 4 weeks, but you can pay for rush fees. We get a lot of questions from our viewers about how do I compete with somebody who's turning around in 3 days or in 7 days if my turnaround's 2 weeks. One of the best ways to do that is to offer it, but to offer a rush fee, because you don't want to disrupt your production in a crazy way. Lastly, last thing I want to show you, in the bottom right-hand corner under Contact Us, they have a text option. And this really speaks to the market that they are approaching with college students, with most millennials. All of the studies that are out there on millennials right now, they prefer text message to phone conversation. I'm like on the edge of millennial, and I definitely prefer text messages to phone conversations, because I don't like people, but... That's a whole nother episode that we have here.
We don't have time to go
there. No, we don't have time to go there. But do you offer text messaging to your customers? I would imagine that your better customers, you probably communicate with via text now. So offer it to inbound leads as well. It's easy to track and it makes communication quick.
Yeah, and an interesting finding we just got back, I think I mentioned on last week's show, from Atlantic City, and we did another blueprint shop visit that's in editing right now, will be published there. But this particular company found that they were able to close more sales by following up through text. Mm-hmm. So it's not only allowing your customers to communicate with you, but it's the outbound communication and follow up with them tends to filter through the clutter. Imagine how many telemarketing calls and phone calls you get. Imagine how many spam emails you get. You don't really get that many text messages. So it's a way to get in front of their device and up towards the front where you're not competing for attention.
Mm-hmm. All right, any more questions come in, Joe, from GoTo? All right, so I think that about wraps us up for this episode of Company Profiles. Again, this was the 85th episode. Stahls has been in business 85 years. And our theme this year is that our customers are the legends of those 85 years of business here at Stahls. So we thank you, our customers, and our viewers for joining us this morning, and we'll see you next week.
Thanks.